guys, welcome back to my channel. So if you're new here, it's lovely to have you. But if you're old, hey boo, it's nice to have you back. My name is Akudede, and today's video, we're gonna make this beautiful, delicious, easy, classic Ghana pancakes or crepes. Now, this is very easy to put together and it's not too sweet. That is because I like to add toppings, extra toppings to mine. So if you want yours without toppings, you go ahead and double the measurements for the sugar in the recipe in the description box below. So let's get right into the video. Now for this, you're gonna need some all-purpose flour, we're gonna need some eggs, some milk, and I'm using evaporated milk in this video, so it appears quite thick. You can use any type of milk you like. I'm using some melted margarine, vanilla essence, some water, some sugar, some nutmeg powder, and then some salt. First of all, we're going to mix our dry ingredients. So there goes my nutmeg, salt, and sugar all into the flour. And we're going to give this a good mix to combine everything together. Once that is done, we're going to set it aside and go on to mix the wet ingredients. Now, I'm going to explain why I have 4 eggs. This recipe doesn't really call for 4 eggs, but my eggs are quite small. That's why I'm using 4. So if you have large eggs, very large eggs, you can use 2. If you have medium-sized eggs, you can use 3. But mine are small. That's why I'm using 4. So once we're done cracking all our eggs, we're going to go on and add our milk. Now see how thick that is. You can go ahead and use whatever milk you have available. Full cream, semi-skimmed, any kind of milk you like. Okay, and if you don't want too much color to your pancakes, then go ahead and use milk that is whitish in color, okay? Because this is giving us that rich Ghanaian color. Okay, that's why we're using ideal milk. This is ideal milk. Now I've added all of my other wet ingredients except my melted margarine. That is going to go in lastly or finally before we fry. Now we're going to add the wet and the dry ingredients together and mix them very well until they are both very well combined. And then we're going to add a melted margarine and then we can fry. So easy, right? It's really easy and simple to put together, yet delicious. It's so good. I mean, it's so good. You know, this is also sometimes a street food. Lately, I don't see it around, but when I was a kid, I used to see it around a lot, selling pancakes in the evening or in the nights on the streets, and we went buy some after we've had dinner, and it's so delicious and it's so good. For those, they don't add toppings, so the sugar and everything is in the pancakes. So good. So now we've added our melted margarine. You're gonna give that also a good mix, and then we check for the consistency. If it's too thick for you, please go ahead and add a little more water. But if you feel like the consistency is perfect, then just go ahead and fry. I'm going to be frying this in my nonstick pan. I think this is about a 10-inch nonstick pan, and I'm using some unsalted butter. This is going to add flavor to my pancakes as well. And now I'm going to be scooping the same quantity for every single pancake, okay? So that we know that nobody's cheating anybody. Everybody's getting the same size. And it also makes the pancakes look really presentable and attractive and nice. Imagine having big, small, and all that. Nah, we're not about that kind of life. We want that perfection on our plate. So go ahead and flip it and then fry it to your satisfaction. Now let me tell you guys something. When it comes to pancakes, I love burnt pancakes. Yes. How it's looking now, it's not okay for me, but that's how I fry it for the rest of the people. But when I'm making mine, you'll be seeing it very soon. I like mine dark. It's delicious. And it adds some crispiness to the edges. So good. So I'm going to teach you 2 ways that I style or that I plate my pancakes. Now this is, I don't know what shape to call this one, but I usually do that one. So just flip in the middle and then flip over and then that's it, voila. Is that an envelope or what? I don't know, you let me know in the comment section below. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I hope this convinces you enough to do so. Why don't you hit on the subscribe button and hit on the bell so you're notified anytime I upload a new content. So many amazing videos over here on this channel. And over here we cook, we love. So everything we cook is so good, so delicious, and so beautiful. Also, give this video a thumbs up and leave questions or comments in the comment section below. I love to hear from you guys. I can't stress on that enough. Now I'm going to be showing you another way that I plate my pancakes, okay? So in my previous video, I had some of you saying you wanted me to teach you how to plate and all that good stuff because I have people commenting on how I plate all the time. So I'm going to be doing that in this video. Now look, this is exactly what I was talking about. This is how I love my pancakes, burnt. It is so good and so flavorful. If you try this one, I don't think you would try the other one. It's so good, like this color, this texture and all that, everything going on here is perfection. Okay, now I'm going to be teaching you how I garnished this particular plate, and it was inspired by Natasha's Kitchen on YouTube. I mean, when I saw all the fruits on hers, I loved it, or her crepes. I loved it. I was like, why don't I get some fruits too? Because I mean, I use these fruits all the time. So on the plate, I have some raspberries, some blackberries. I'm going to be adding some blueberries and some strawberries as well. Love it. It's going to be beautiful. So this is how you do it, and then try it, and it's going to be perfection. If you don't have these fruits available, you can use some slices of oranges or lemons or the peels. You can use some apples to do something beautiful. You will love it. I mean, go ahead and use what you're comfortable with, okay? And then make your dishes beautiful. Now this is mine, this is how I like to do mine, because I love colors and I love these fruits. Like I said, I use them all the time, so I always have them available at home. Now tell me this isn't beautiful. This is so beautiful, and I love, love, love it. Look at that. I don't know how your guests will feel about this, but I know mine did die for this, okay? It's so amazing, so beautiful. It makes your plates or your plating or your table so colorful, and it's so inviting. Trust me, sometimes people don't even want to touch it because they don't want to ruin it. They're like, no, this is so beautiful, I don't even want to touch it and ruin it. Go ahead and eat it. Okay, we made it to eat. Now this is another one. I have the crepe or the pancake on a plate, and then I'm going to drizzle some chocolate on it. So good. Remember, our crepes or our pancakes are not too sweet. So these extra toppings, they add fire, okay? They balance everything out, and then everything is just so delicious. It's not overly sweet. For this one, I melted golden tree chocolate. So that's like semi-sweet chocolate. And then I drizzled it on it. And on goes some raspberries and some blueberries. Simple, but so beautiful. And over here, I have some strawberries, raspberries, and blueberries supporting my pancakes. And I'm drizzling some powdered sugar onto it. Okay, later on, I added some drizzle of chocolate, but I didn't show that. We're going to be seeing it in the end. So these are authentic Ghana pancakes. Don't get it twisted. We just garnished it and took it to the next level. I hope you enjoyed it. Now for the giveaway, I wanted to just say it, but I believe recording it will be better. So I'll be filming a short, very short video and then explain the giveaway to you guys. So please stay tuned, and stay tuned on my socials, my Instagram and my Facebook, because we are going to be sharing it there as well as on my Twitter. Thank you for watching, and see you soon.